Here are my 5 best dumbbell exercises for men for a well-rounded athletic physique and why you need to include them in your training. So first up, we've got the incline dumbbell bench press. Most people will choose a flat bench press over an incline. However, I'm encouraging you, for a better shape and a better physique, try doing more incline than flat. You can feel the chest out from the top then, hitting the upper pecs, which is much harder to hit than the lower pecs, which are gonna be involved in an incline bench press anyway. Now, one of the biggest mistakes I see on this is just the setup, getting the dumbbells into place. And also, whilst you're doing the set, make sure you've got the seat up one notch, because if not, you'll probably slide forwards and turn it back into a flat bench press. So let's talk about the setup. So just get the dumbbells onto your knees without hurting your lower back. Now, I've got a little bit of spring in my calves, which is gonna help me to get the dumbbells into place. As I go back, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna bring my knees with me, and then I'm gonna return my legs back to the floor once the dumbbells are in place. I'm gonna lean forwards, backwards momentum, and return the legs. Throughout your set, we want to focus on a slower eccentric lowering phase and then press into the top. And then when you're done, I'd turn them back neutral. Bring your knees up a little bit, catch them, and just saves you a lot of wasted effort and reduces the risk of tearing something in your shoulder. If you're trying to aim for that well-rounded physique, don't ignore the lower half of your body. This goblet squat is a great way to build your quads and stop you walking around with little stick legs. Okay, so pick it up without ruining your back. I like to go into a deadlift position, drive, and hook my hands underneath. We're gonna have elbows in tight, chest up high. I like to think hips go down low, dumbbell stays up high, to stop you from leaning forwards. The dumbbell is going to act like a counterweight, meaning that you should be able to be a bit more upright than a back squat. You want your knees driving to the outside, heels stay on the floor. If you're struggling with mobility, just put some little plates under your heels and it'll help you to stay upright. Make sure your heels stay in contact with those plates throughout the set. So the dumbbell goblet squat, great quad builder. Make sure you're doing it regularly. So some of the most visible muscles we have out in everyday life is gonna be your biceps and your triceps. So it'd be stupid to ignore these in the top 5 dumbbell exercises. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna do an incline bicep curl. We're gonna use the bench with the incline to take your ego out of the lift and make sure we can keep the isolation on the bicep. Because when you're leaning back like this, it's gonna be a lot harder to cheat than if you were standing, where your knees and your hips might swing and start helping out. So if you take the dumbbells, you're gonna lean back. Now keep your elbows back fairly far. I like to start with a neutral grip and then we're gonna twist. I actually tap the sides of my chest with the dumbbell and then back down to a full stretch. So big twist. Make sure you're getting the twist at the top. Your bicep not only closes your elbow joint, but it also turns your forearm in that action. Having that incline makes it a lot harder. So you'll have to use a lighter weight, but it'll get you a really good workout. Make sure you're controlling the way down. Squeeze at the top, big twist. So incline bicep curl, great one to build the biceps. Takes the ego out of the lift, having the backboard, and you're gonna have to use a slightly lighter weight. So when you're training your arms, you wanna be doing at least the same amount of tricep sets as you are bicep sets. If not even more tricep sets, as they are making up a bigger portion of your arm. So we've got a dumbbell skull crusher, or a tricep extension, if you want to call it that. Now there's a tip on this that is going to really help you get the most out of the exercise, and it's about the start position. So the start position, we want a slight angle here. So although my elbows are straight, I'm going to start and finish with this slight slope. So you're going to lower the dumbbells down just above your ears, and then extend to straight, squeezing the triceps. But we're not actually gonna bring the dumbbells back over the chest. We're gonna extend them here. That's gonna maintain time under tension, which will lead to results in muscle growth. In order to maintain a good posture and not be overly rounded forwards, you need to make sure you're hitting your back muscles as much as you're hitting your push muscles. Again, if not slightly more on the back work. So here we have basically the opposite movement of the incline bench press. We're gonna do a prone dumbbell row. Prone just means you're face down on the bench. Now, a big mistake that also looks funny is people will sit on the bench and have their face in the bench like this, which isn't particularly hygienic and it's definitely not very comfortable. So my top tip on this is start with straight legs, put your hands on the bench, keep your legs straight and lower your hips and chest. So we've got a straight line from heels and you're not face planting the bench. So you're gonna take the dumbbells, big pull, pull up and back towards your hips. So a mistake I see on this is that people pull up in a straight line, but what we actually want to do is pull up and back slightly. So make sure you're including the prone dumbbell row in your workouts to maintain that good posture. So that's it. Hopefully you picked up some tips that you can incorporate into your own training, or at least were inspired to get out and lift some dumbbells. I wanna know, what would your 5 top dumbbell exercises be for developing a well-rounded athletic physique? Put it in the comments and I'll comment back to you. Also, if you enjoyed the content, please hit the thumbs up button and give the video a like. Check out my channel for follow-along videos. There's a load of dumbbell ones on there as well. And subscribe if you're enjoying it and you don't wanna miss any content.